For me, the VP of data science part has come only in the last couple of months. After several attempts at bringing in data science champions from the outside of the industry, the personnel at Sony Pictures decided that it would probably be better to take someone who's entrenched in the Sony Pictures culture and make them a data scientist as opposed to use what they had been doing, which is bringing in an expert from the outside and having them not necessarily be as steeped in the Sony culture and have that be a force of contention for people as they were trying to establish their tenure there. For me, I've been with the company for 12 years, and so before that, I was in charge of global reporting and analytics. And so as a result of that, that makes it for an easier transition from having done analytics before and then extending it to now include data science. We have a reputation for being an industry in which people are either rewarded or heralded for their gut reactions to things. And I think what we're looking for in many cases is providing the CEO or the president with an informed gut, allowing them to make decisions that are enhanced by data, not necessarily replacing their gut reactions to certain things. And so as a result of providing this additional information to them, we feel that we're putting them in a better position to make decisions that will ultimately yield a more profitable either movie or television show for our company. Not as much market research as it is sort of secondary research. So we do a lot of analysis of former TV shows or movies in order to be able to establish what kinds of trends we're seeing in the industry, and then use that to inform the kind of strategy we should have on a title when we release it to the wider audience. I think one of the best ways we can do that is by showing how this information has been helpful in providing us with better decisions up until this point. I think one of the things that has been most interesting is that in our release of movies in the last year and a half, we have done a much better job of exceeding the market in our releases, both in terms of sell-through and their rental performance. And I think this establishes the principle by which we can go back to the CEO or the president and say, we've done these experiments, we found that we've been in a better position in order to use this data to make decisions. I think this can greatly enhance the decisions that you'd like to make now with another part of our release strategy or some other aspect of the movie business for them. Most of our roles right now are purely for data science, though we are looking for other people that can provide or enhance our ability beyond that. But the data science role is paramount at this point. We're looking for people who have a great knowledge and or desire to be in the entertainment industry. I think there is a saying that one has to love the widget that they're looking at. And so we really use that as a way of being able to test to see whether a candidate is going to be appropriate for the role that we are trying to fill. So not only do they need to be able to do the analysis, but they need to be able to communicate the results of it to anyone who may need to know what we have found in our work. Most definitely. I think one of the things that we are often seeking are people who are really steeped in entertainment knowledge beyond just the knowledge of different data science techniques that can benefit us. We find that that actually helps a great deal with regard to not only them retaining interest in our area, but also being able to find new and different ways of analyzing the information in our area to continue to build the profitability and other insights that may be beneficial to our company as a whole. Well, that's a very good question. Our recruitment drives are greatly impacted by this need to try to find what we seem like, what would seem like a unicorn in terms of having a great interest in entertainment, but also having a very scientifically and analytically driven mind. I think one of the things that we have found is that people in either engineering backgrounds or science backgrounds are usually very effective in being able to contribute to us. Also, their love of movies and entertainment in general is usually very high up there as well in terms of our most successful candidates. I think it's what really drives the knowledge and the passion that they have. For many, it's a desire to not only do the work that they have currently, but a desire to explore, well, what is really behind one title doing better than another one, and using that information in order to further drive insights for our business. I think it really is in terms of the hiring. Once we have found the right person, they have a tendency to stay. For the staffs that I have managed over the last 12 years that I've been at Sony, very few people have left. They've only really left if they've been able to find a much better opportunity someplace else, and so they really have only left to be promoted into a position that's better. I think one of the things that we have been able to do with our group is always provide sufficiently interesting topics and points of analysis such that people's interest gets piqued, and then they are able to provide solutions to those problems as they present themselves. But people are usually very excited about coming to work each day and what they get to contribute to the business overall. That's been a little bit difficult because I think as of late it's been stagnant. And if anything, that's really been a tendency toward how do you maintain the people in the group, because there have always been constant threats of layoffs. But I think one of the things that people have found with our group is that we are a group that's very beneficial to the bottom line, one that actually is providing insights in a time where those insights are most important in order to be able to capture more of a shrinking pie. And as a result of that, that's built up some ability to leverage against the possibility of losing people under those circumstances. The three most important aspects of being an effective CAO, I believe, would be one that has an overall vision for the company, and one that actually allows us to determine where we need to be in terms of a business and exactly how we can go about following the steps to get there. I think the person also needs to be steeped in the company culture and the company's objectives, knowing exactly what it is that will allow us to reach profitability on many different movies and television shows. And then finally, they need to also have knowledge of the business and knowledge of the industry in general, knowledge of the kinds of things that we can do as a company that will provide the ability to better service not only our internal customers, but our external customers as well. Well, one of the things, admittedly, that we haven't been necessarily taking advantage of is natural language processing. So we realize now that social media is a bigger part of our business, and what may compel a person to either attend or not attend a movie, it's the same aspects that will compel a person to either buy or not buy one of our movies once they reach the home video stage. So being able to find out what it is that is among the things that people really like about the film versus the ones that they don't, and what may cause them to do a trade-off between renting and buying, are the things that we would like to find out more. And so social media, I believe, is an aspect by which we can determine some of those things at least. And I think being able to do more of that analysis and provide that as inputs to our models will be able to benefit us overall. I think that can be challenging at times. I think there are instances in which we have looked at different things and noticed that there has been more of a trend. So for instance, one of the things that we were finding more and more on the theatrical side that hasn't necessarily seemed to have bearing on the home entertainment side yet is what the Rotten Tomatoes score on a movie will be. That seems to more directly be contributing to whether people attend the movie, especially in that opening weekend, based on whether it's gotten good reviews. We haven't necessarily seen as direct a correlation between that and then how that movie will do on home entertainment. But we believe that there is this aspect of a title will sell better if people actually like it. And so finding out exactly what parameters are there that will actually point to that as an explanatory variable are among the ones that we're constantly seeking. We do know and have had success with looking at, for instance, the cinema score on a title and using that as a proxy for that particular measure. I think a lot of it is having passion for what it is that you're doing. I think there are always going to be challenges with regard to the work that you wind up doing as a group, or the errors that you may wind up making in trying to pursue different forms of analysis. But I think the passion and the drive that you show in what you are doing is going to be especially important in terms of really being able to provide the impetus for not only you and your group to really be able to sit in there and work hard and continue to try to make great contributions for your organization.